So in this video, I'm going to show you a technique that I'm going to use with all three different kinds of ink so that you can see how to use it in your projects. I'm going to be working on the Strathmore watercolor paper, though in the picture that I work on later, I use the mixed media paper. I'm going to be using the Aquafine watercolor ink in quinacridone magenta and cerulean hue in this first demo. And I am going to start by taking a wet brush and I'm just going to dampen down the paper and create a little like wet patch. And then I'm going to just go ahead and drop in one drop of each ink on either side of the paper. They're going to start blending towards each other. And then I'm going to use a brush to blend them in towards each other. I am starting by using a larger, more pointed brush, but then I move in with this flat shader brush by Princeton that I really enjoy. It's great for that subtle blending. And then I'm going to use a little spray bottle just to spritz the top of this. This can help blend it a little bit more. It can also give a little bit of a mottled texture. So if you don't want that texture, then maybe this is not the best technique for you, but I like that texture. I'm now going to use the FW. This is acrylic ink, and I'm going to be using the fluorescent blue and the fluorescent pink. Because these are acrylic inks, they are different than watercolor in the sense that they're not going to budge and blend and move once they're dry, which is awesome for layering. But these ones, being neons, are more translucent than some of the other acrylic inks, both in the FW line and then the System 3 line is like all opaque. This is actually really nice because it enables you to use glazing techniques if you want to, which is where you use a thinner paint over something that you've built up to change the color. And it's really, really useful to play around with your paints beforehand so that you can see how they blend and the way that different colors work. For the System 3, I am using cadmium red because I didn't have a magenta in this ink line. And you can see the way that the red and the blue blend to create a purple is completely different. So this is a really good exercise to play around with your inks or supplies, whatever you're using, to see how they blend and what colors they make. It's always good to play around with your supplies before you go into start a painting. So now that I've shown you a basic way of blending the colors together, I'm going to show you a little bit more about the colors. So this is the neon, and as you can see, when I lay it over all three of them, it's super translucent. If I mix it in with the FW white, it becomes pretty opaque, although a little bit lighter. And with the System 3, it also becomes really opaque. I think maybe just a little bit more opaque than the FW. I can also lay down white beforehand. I'm using the System 3 here, and then I lay the FW neon on top. You can see this creates an even brighter, more vibrant, opaque look with the neon. So this is a great way to get an opaque look. Now I'm going to show you how the Aquafine reacts differently to the System 3 and acrylic inks. You can see that you can lift it up and you can rework it once it's dried. In the next video, I'll go over some mixed media techniques and talk about why you might want to use mixed media in your project.